Hello from Inspire UI. Today we will show you how to use Lust Builder to build a Flutter app page on a WordPress template. Waiting no more, let's get started. First thing first, all we need to do is login, which I already did here. Then come back to the home page. We're gonna choose one of the following templates here. Now I'm going to choose WordPress. This is an example of the plus new project. Now let's make our old site. Now I'm going to paste on our demo site, which is TechCrunch. This is a startup and technology new paste on a WordPress template. Now we're going to analyze the connection between Plus Builder and this site. As we can see here, the image cache is not completed because there's a lack of necessary blocking in this site. But this is just a demo. It won't affect much on our code. Now, move to the next step. We have two options, whether we can load the localization data file, but I don't have one, so I'm going to choose one of the available templates which are built by the Inspire UI team. Now let me see. I love this one. This looks simple. Simple, different, you know. And now let's move to the design part. As we can see here in the top bar, we have totally four screens: the home page, the category screen, Quizlish, and the search screen. There are four items in the top bar as well. Now I want to add another screen. Let me see which is going to be the row 5 screen, so that the user can log in and communicate with our system. I want to change the icon here as well because it's not relevant to the row 5 screen. Let me see, it's going to be this one. And now come back to the Quizlish screen. The item here is not relevant as well, so I'm gonna change it into something like this hot button. It looks great. Yeah, now I have four screens in total. And now let me see the data in the home page is duplicate. Now let's customize it a little bit in the logo header. Currently, it just shows the search icon. What if I want to change so it can show the left-hand side menu as well? Left-hand side icon menu as well. And the label is going to be TechCrunch. Save. I want to edit this header text as well. And this is going to be Startup and technology news, and let's increase the font size a little bit. Yeah, it looks great. It's not this layout. The banner image layout is not look good in the whole app, so I'm gonna delete it by swap to the left hand side of this item, and then this will be removed. This slider block list, what if I want to change to another category? Let me see, blockchain. Yeah, the web file. Blog channel. So what I'm doing here is change the label here. So instead of showing recent recipe, gonna show the blockchain news. The image border is too large, it's too circular. I wanna make it like 8, I think is enough. And image size, I want it to be the left hand side as well. Yeah, great. This layout and this layout seem duplicate. So why don't we make it to stand next to each other? I can do it by move the item here, just above the another slider block list. Yeah, it seems great. I want to change the image border as well. In the cutter screen developer. Great, it looks much better now. So let's customize the to rest. Cutter screen gonna be the cloud session. Okay, this one is gonna be biotech news. Okay, what if I wanna add another layout? We can do it here by tap into this button, add more layout. So I'm gonna choose let me see, banner image, large block cast, just seem great. Yeah, that's just what I want. Book review self, and then the display here. But this one seem not really shy on the whole layout, so I'm gonna change it out here a little bit. So let's make it like stack. Great. Yeah, just what I need. But I want it to be in the bottom. Let the whole app. Great. Okay, we have done with the data initialization as well as the design part. Now let's move to the final part, which is public ESI. At this step, I highly recommend you should take a look back to your whole app to see whether or not it looks okay. If it is, now we have to pay on our purchase call, which we can get from the Evento Market, and click on Active License. List Builder will automatically generate the whole session file here for us, and then all we have to do is just copy this one and paste into our app config. And now this is the result when we done with pasting our JSON file into the PlusNew app. Everything works perfectly. Okay, this is the end of the video. Thank you for watching.